Hey, what's up everybody? This is Jesse with Minimalist Accounting, and I have an awesome video for you guys today on the accrual basis accounting reconciliation using the accounting equation. In this video, we're going to begin by looking at the steps involved in the reconciliation process, followed by the accounting equation and the manipulation of that equation. And I personally love problems, so I'm going to give you one of those too and wrap it up with a quick and easy example. In the last video, we learned how to solve one of the two questions that you're most likely to see under the topic of accrual accounting. In this video, we will tackle the second problem of reconciling accrual net income to cash basis net income and vice versa using the accounting equation. Let's jump right in. Let's begin by looking at the overall steps involved in the reconciliation process. First, we will identify the correct configuration of the accounting equation depending on what needs to be converted to what. Two, we will begin our calculation with the given value of the net income. And three, we will add or subtract change in assets and liabilities from the net income using the accounting equation as a guide. Now I'm sure you're all aware of ale, the crisp, clean, and frizzy beer with a nice balance of hops and malts, contributing flavors of... I meant the accounting equation. Assets, liabilities, and equity. That's how I remember it. Ale beer. Classic. Let's look at how we can manipulate the accounting equation to first convert net income from accrual to cash. Let's add a delta to both sides of the equation, which refers to change or increase or decrease in that value. We can further split the assets into cash and OA for other assets. Rearranging this equation yields us delta cash equals delta L minus delta OA. We are going to use this equation as a guide to know whether to add or subtract the change in assets and liabilities. Moving on to the reconciliation of cash to accrual net income. We are simply going to rearrange the equation to read delta E equals delta A minus delta L. This means that we would add any increase in assets and subtract any increases in liabilities to net income. Note that the signs in this equation are the opposite of what we saw above. Here's a quick little tip if you ever get confused over the two equations. Remember that when the question asks you to convert to cash net income, we need to solve for delta C. Hence, the rearrangement would be delta C equals delta L minus delta A. You get the idea? Okay, let's look at an example to help put it all together. Dope Company reported its net income of $35,200 on the cash basis. Corporate records reveal the following. We have some beginning AR and ending AR. And we have beginning unearned revenue and ending unearned revenue. The question asks, what amount of income should Dope report under the accrual basis? Okay, so from just reading that question, we can gather that we are given the net income in cash basis and need to reconcile it to accrual basis. Let's start by pulling up the steps involved in the reconciliation process and follow its directions. Step 1, identify the correct configuration of the accounting equation. Okay, so we know that this is from cash to accrual net income, which means that we are going to use delta E equals delta A minus delta L to help us solve this problem. Step 2, begin with the given value of the net income. Okay, we got that. We have cash net income equaling $35,200. Gotcha. Now, final step, step 3, the most important one. We're going to add or subtract the change in assets and liabilities using the accounting equation as a guide. Looking back at the questions, we noticed that that there has been an increase in the accounts receivable account, which is an asset account, by the way, by $500. The accounting equation dictates that we add any increase in change in assets, so we add the change of $500 back into the cash basis net income. Following the same with the unearned revenue account, which is liability, we notice that the account decreased by $450. The accounting equation tells us that we should subtract any change in increase in the liability account. Now let's jot that down. And tallying the final answer gives us an accrual net income of $36,150. Ta-da! I hope that this example helped put the theory into practice a little bit so you can see just how easy the reconciliation problems are. And just one last thing I want to address before we wrap this up. If the question asks you to reconcile accrual expense to cash basis expense and vice versa, simply switch the signs around as shown in this comparison table here. In summary, remember the very important accounting equation when solving reconciliation problems from accrual to cash basis net income or expense and vice versa. Here are the configurations that you need to remember to ace that test. Good luck! Stay tuned for more easy accounting tutorials. And as always, thanks for watching. Happy counting!